So you've installed the CrumplePop audio plugins. What next? Well, my name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'm going to show you the right way to use them. Now, I'm going to be using this in Adobe Premiere Pro, but the same ideas apply wherever you're using these plugins, and we have host-specific tutorials on our website. So let's take a listen to the first clip.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
So there's a few things we want to clean up in this shot. We have the audio, it's a little bit too low. We have the noise of the vacuum cleaner in the background, and we also have room echo. So there's a bit of reverb in this room, which is obviously not being treated. So if we take a look at our CrumplePop effects, we have a number of different plugins that are dealing with, you know, very specific things, but there's one filter that you should always start with, and that is Voice Enhance Complete. Now, the temptation is to just drag this over a clip, and we can do this if we're just working on a single clip. I would suggest that you don't succumb to that temptation and instead apply this effect across an entire track instead. And in Premiere Pro, we can do that by going to the Audio Track Mixer and opening up our effects area at the top. Now, your specific host will have different ways of dealing with track audio, but the idea is the same. So we've got our dialogue on audio track one, which is this one here, and I'm going to go a few effects down, and I'm going to choose my voice enhance. And I'll just double click on the voice enhance to bring up the interface. And let's have a little playback.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
And that's done a really nice job. That's brought the voice a lot more forward. That's taken out the reverb and taken out most of the noise. Let's hear it before and after.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
Now, you might hear that there's a little bit of noise at the front and the back. What we could do is we could try to change up the strength here. So a strength of zero keeps all the noise in.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
And I wouldn't really move this too far away from the defaults. Generally, I'll move this between, you know, maybe 60 and 85, but your clips may be different. But that's the sweet spot for me. One of the things we could be doing is also changing the model. So we have three different models. One is for indoor use. One is indoor noisy. So this changes up the background a little bit here, but it can help when you have a bit more of a noisiness in the background.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
And then we have our outdoor model as well. And this is better for when you're outdoors. So the models sort of speak for themselves. But that still doesn't fix our little noisiness at the top and tail of this particular clip. So one of the nice things about the CrumplePop voice enhance is that it's all processed on your computer. So it's not sent back off up into the cloud, processed, and then comes back again. Now, this means that we can add in more filters inside that chain. So what if I came into my clips again, and upstream of the voice enhance, I did something like a dynamics or dynamics processing. Let's try dynamics here. And I'll just turn off the voice enhance, back into dynamics, and maybe we'll just mark out the last little section here and just loop this around. So in this way, I can find the right threshold for the noise gate, because what we don't want to do is we don't want to take out too much stuff here. We just want to take out the noise itself. So I'll find that moment where we start to tip over. It's around about minus 37 in this clip. And let's turn our voice enhance back on and play this back now.
When you come home after a long day, you want nothing else but silence.
So now we've got the noise gate taking out the first base level of noise, and then we're working on the voice enhance to actually do the hard work. Now we can use the same idea with different CrumplePop effects as well. So let's have a listen to this next clip.
Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions. Make it yours with MySpot.
And let's play around the second part of the clip and have a little listen.
Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions. Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions.
So we've got quite a lot of echo in there, like, you know, nice bit of reverb. So we'll come back into our audio effects and we can see that there's one called Echo Remover. But stop any temptation you have to immediately put that on. The first thing we should always try is, of course, the voice enhance.
Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions. Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions.
Now that sounds pretty good already, even at default settings. Now you might notice if you turn it up really high.
Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions.
We're still maybe getting a little bit of the echo in there. I don't mind it in this case, but if you do, what we can do is come in here, go to the restoration, and upstream, let's put in the echo remover.
Take the guesswork out of bulky objects with true-to-life dimensions.
And this is a trick I do quite often. Now, the final thing to remember when we're dealing with any of the CrumplePop effect is that we are going to be getting out a mono sound at the end of it. So these filters have been designed to work on voice and dialogue for the most part. And that is going to be mono for the most part. Let's have a little listen to this clip, though. Autumn is that time of year where things are starting to change. And there's nothing that exemplifies change much more than coming in and looking around the forest. Okay, so you might have noticed there was a little bit of difference between the left and the right ear. And that's because there were two different mic sources going in to this clip. Let's apply voice enhance to this and let's see what happens. Autumn is that time of year where things are starting to change. And there's nothing that exemplifies change much more than coming in and looking around the forest. Okay, so the output we're getting now when we've used voice enhance is a mono output. It's a dual mono output. And we can see it over on the VU meters over here. Autumn is that time of year where things are starting to change. So we've got, you know, the same signal on the left and right. If I turn off the voice enhance, we play this back. Autumn is that time of year where things are starting to change. There we go. So you can see there's a difference between the left and right. So the important thing here is to remember to set up your clip correctly. I'm going to go into my bin and I'll find the clip that I was working on here. I'm going to right click on this. And I'm going to modify my audio channels. And my current settings say that the media source left is going to the clip left and the media source right is going to the clip right. I'm just going to make sure that both of these are now set to right. I could do this set to left. Either way, we want dual mono. Let's play this back. Autumn is that time of year where things are starting to change. So we can now see that we've got both and left and right,
exemplifies.
And I can come in now with my voice enhanced.
And there's nothing that exemplifies change much more than coming in and looking around the forest.
And be sure that I fixed up my clip in the right way using the correct starting point. So those are a few quick tips for getting started with CrumplePop. Always start with voice enhance. Don't be afraid to add in anything upstream if you think that that's going to help the signal. And always check to make sure that you're using the right audio channels. CrumplePop effects will be processing these out as mono clips. So they're designed for dialogue, which is going to be mono. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. Check out more CrumplePop tips and tricks on the Boris Effects website or join our community on the forums or Discord channel, links down below. See you again soon.